Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, don't you agree that social media has become an issue? Everyone is on social media, be it WhatsApp, Telegram, or Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, whatever it may be. There are so many platforms that some of those names we don't know. My brothers and sisters, people sometimes go onto social media in order to find validation. People want likes, they want follows, they want to be famous, they want to make money sometimes because they've heard that you can make money, and therefore they end up doing silly things that are at times displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or compromising their own morals and values in order to achieve that. If you're going to do something silly in order to get a like or two, you might get more than just one or two likes, but it will come at a price. Really, long term, it's not going to go down well. Similarly, if you're doing something that is unacceptable in terms of what Allah has ordained as a believer, obviously those who don't believe, perhaps this wouldn't help them. But if you're a believer, what has Allah taught? He's taught you to be disciplined, to hold high morals and values, and that discipline would actually bring about contentment and happiness and so much more. If you want to be content and happy, you need to be disciplined. That discipline will bring about the fulfillment of goodness, that even if you're using social media, which is not a bad thing on its own, it's the way we use it. A lot of people have learned so much from the different platforms. Nonetheless, when you find something negative, you need to know how to interact with it. You need to know how to keep scrolling. Don't waste your time with it. Stop at that which you believe is beneficial. The minute it meanders into territory that is no longer beneficial, keep rolling. And there you will be able to benefit and protect yourself. But on the flip side of it, like I was saying, if we're going to just have fun and say, this is just banter, what type of banter? Like I say, it comes at a price. Because what happens is, we always speak about connecting with Allah. Connecting with Allah. When you're disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're on your own. So it might seem like there are thousands of people with you, but you're actually on your own because you've disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what happens? Now you're encouraged to do even more silly things. And then it doesn't stop there. You start living for people, no longer for Allah. So my life rotates around me showing people everything, whatever they want to see, anything that makes them happy. And you know what? For as long as they're giving me, they call it gifts or money, for as long as I'm earning, I'm happy. Because that's my source of income. What type of income is that? Is it filled with blessing? Number one, you disconnected yourself from Allah in order to have an income. I'm talking about believers. Number two is the income came in through something that you believe in your own belief structure, that it's immoral and it's not of the best of values or unacceptable in terms of values and morals. How then would you think the future is going to pan out? May Allah Almighty protect us. This is why we say social media is not easy to navigate, but it's not harmful on its own. It's how you use it that would determine whether it is acceptable or not in terms of its use. Like I just said, many people have learned so much. In fact, there is a lot out there to learn, so much to see, and it's good. You can either use it in a beneficial way, benefit yourself, or you can benefit others. Or there is no benefit and no harm. That's okay still. But the moment it crosses the threshold and starts harming, it's either going to harm you and the people who follow you, perhaps. You start showing them things, they start following what you're doing. Or you see what they do and you begin to do what they're doing. It's no longer about Allah. It's about them. It's about us. It's about a community I've built of people I'd never meet in real life. Some of them I may, but it's people I don't even know. I'm trying to impress. And the people I live with, they mean nothing. So it becomes so difficult because there we are. We're out there and what we're doing is we're on social media out for the likes and the follows and everything else. Let's be careful. You don't need to be known. You don't need to be a famous person. Trust me, it comes at a price. Yes, if Allah has allowed and you've worked in a good way to whatever it may be your business, it may be faith-based, it may be something you're teaching worldly, it may be, for as long as it's something permissible, it may be a brand you have, it may be something you're showcasing, it may be your artwork, it may, whatever it may be, for as long as it's something permissible, inshallah, Allah will allow you to grow. Yes, you work hard, you want it to get out there, inshallah it will. But don't compromise your link with Allah to achieve that. That's all I'm saying. That if we are going to compromise our link with Allah, we've failed in our use of social media. It will be bearing witness against us on the day of judgment. And just like there would be millions of people following a good example, there would also be millions of people following a terrible example. So if you are to say something positive and people followed you, it's going to bear witness for you. And if you're going to say something negative and people follow you, then it's going to bear witness against you on that day. Therefore, be careful. People sometimes say things that are so nasty. The comment section on a lot of social media platforms is hilarious, but it's sad at the same time, because people who are generally supposed to be believers, worried about and concerned about the day of judgment, they don't even think what they're saying, what they're talking about. You haven't ever met this person, you haven't given them a chance to clarify, you don't even know what's going on, and here you are with the biggest and dirtiest and filthiest comments that are not actually you. So it's not you, but you didn't think about it. You know why? You disconnected, unplugged from Allah before you plugged in with shaitan. And you didn't think. So you just started commenting, saying one thing after another. No matter how pious you think you are, that's not acceptable. So let's consider this. Let us in these blessed days think about what we type and what we say online. It's very dangerous. It's something that a single word would actually cause the tipping of our scales either this way or that way. The hadith says, whoever believes in Allah and the last day should only utter that which is beneficial or remain silent. If you really believe that there is a day of reckoning, you wouldn't utter a word that is going to be held against you. Because when the scale is put in, you just need one more word to tip it. What if that word was that negative word? I'd rather it be the positive word. Remain silent or say something good. Similarly, if you're going to talk about someone online, and these are some of the difficulties we face with social media, if you say something negative, you don't know what might happen as a result of that. Sometimes the person may see it, they may not see it. So many others might say things, and a whole war has happened behind the back of a person who is online, or maybe sometimes they may know about it. The evil effect of that could be devastating. So don't do that. Let's be very responsible when we use social media and understand it's not all about the likes and the follows. It's not all about making money if it is compromising your values, your morals, and your connection with Allah. If it is connected with Allah, inshallah, whatever you're trying to do will always succeed, even if it is a worldly thing. Like I said, your business, your talent, whatever it may be, may Allah bless you and grant you beautiful growth. Ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama ala nabiyyina Muhammad.